In Europe, in order to protect people's health, authorities can ban certain substances, which pose a considerable risk, even if there is no irrefutable proof yet on their toxicity on human beings. For instance, if in a toxicity study a substance has caused heavy damages to organs of rats and mice, but there are still no scientific data on humans, would you let children play with it? Therefore, in these conditions, as a precaution, in Europe we have the right to restrict them, and their further studies will prove they are safe. This approach is regulated by law and called the Precautionary Principle, also known as better safe than sorry. Some interested parties and lobbies complain that if there is no scientific evidence of damages on humans, that, by the way, most of the time will be available only after a period of use, such chemicals should not be forbidden. The so-called scientific approach, mainly adopted outside the European Union. So, well, you got the idea. From a consumer point of view, while for the precautionary principle mice are good enough, for the scientific approach, the testing animal, at the end of the day, could be you. In European Union, the precautionary principle is a cornerstone of our legal system. However, with free trade agreements like CETA and TTIP, what is legally sold in Canada or US, where the precautionary principle is not strictly applied as it is in Europe, will be allowed to enter the European market, with potentially dangerous chemicals, genetically modified organisms, and so on. Less guaranteed will mean cheaper, and this will also make European companies less competitive, causing job losses. That's why we must fight these free trade agreements and defend what we have. Join us! You can directly ask members of the European Parliament to vote against CETA using CETACheck. Go to the website www.cetacheck.eu or stop-ttip.org. Europe is yours. Don't give it up.